A ninth infant has died from whooping cough or pertussis in California. Joining me now with the latest information about the whooping cough epidemic is KPBS reporter Joanne Farrion. Joanne, officials just confirmed that baby died of complications from whooping cough. Are there any signs that the disease is slowing down?
Actually, no, Gloria. Here in the county, there are signs that it's actually picking up. Just in the last 3 weeks, there have been more than 100 new cases confirmed in the county. August, the end of August, we had more than 300 confirmed cases. Now we have 554 confirmed cases. Also, the state also shows that same trend. This is now the worst epidemic in 55 years.
Why do health officials think that there are sharp increases at this point?
Well, there's a few reasons. First of all, this disease tends to peak in the summer. We're a little late for that. Usually the peak is in July. We're seeing it now in September. Also, kids are going back to school. This is a really contagious disease, so they have more exposure to it. And also, there's so much awareness right now about whooping cough in the community, so there are more people going to their doctor saying, could this be whooping cough? And doctors are testing more for it.
So that's interesting. There's probably more reporting going on, self-reporting about the symptoms of the disease. Now, you did tell us something about the efficacy of the whooping cough vaccine. What's known about how well the vaccine works?
That's really a great question. KPBS looked at data in the past couple of weeks for people who were tested positive for whooping cough. At the time, there were more than 300 positive cases. We found that nearly 2 out of 3, 197 of those cases, those people were completely up to date with their immunizations for whooping cough. So, of course, the question is, why they still get the disease? A number of reasons. First of all, anyone involved in this kind of research, scientists who are involved in the vaccine, say that this vaccine is not 100% effective. Various estimates place it between 80 and 90% effective. We spoke with one world expert who said it's maybe sometimes only 70% effective. And yet other experts who say we ought to be looking at the vaccine, we ought to be looking at the current strain of whooping cough and asking these questions in a more scientific way as well.
So is there any sign that they're going to try to change the vaccine to accommodate to changes in the disease? All diseases change.
Well, one of the lead researchers on this is in the Netherlands, and I've spoken with him frequently on the phone and through email, and he says there is a lot of research now being done in other parts of the world. For example, in Ireland, they found a group of fully vaccinated children who are also getting sick. I came across a paper, a similar story in Israel, so the discussion has begun about this.
Okay, just briefly, do they have a sense of when this is all going to taper off?
Well, Dr. Seidlinger, who is the county deputy health officer, I spoke to him and he said he expects that by next month we should see these numbers go down, and that's because of the cyclical nature of the disease, so you can bet we're going to keep you posted and let you know what happens.
Joanne Farrion, thank you very much.
Thanks, Gloria.